Hello and welcome to BYJU'S IAS. Let's get started and look into our daily quiz. Let's look into the first question. Consider the following pairs. City in use, country, Kunduz, Afghanistan, Talokan, Pakistan, Saripul, Iran. Which of the above pairs is or correctly matched? The answer to this is one only. Why have we taken this practice question? Because this article here makes a mention of all these three cities which were captured by the Taliban. Which are these cities? We have the Saripul, we have Kunduz, followed by Talokan. So kindly remember, all these three important cities are from the country of Afghanistan and not from Pakistan or Iran. When we look into Kunduz, Kunduz is one of the important areas. It is located along the border areas of Tajikistan. So if people have to cross over to Central Asia, if goods have to be sent from Afghanistan to Central Asia, Kunduz become one of the important places. So kindly remember, this is one of the important cities which is also considered as a gateway to some of the important resources in this region. Most of the minerals are also present in this region. So the capture by Taliban could be one of the economic advantages to Taliban. Added to this, there are also highways that are connected from Kunduz to close by to Kabul as well. And capturing this region, they would also be able to control the highways in the region. And in this particular region of Kunduz, since it is connecting to Central Asia, since it has a connection to Tajikistan as well, most of the opium producing regions are also connected from Kunduz to Tajikistan and to Central Asia as well. So the opium that is produced in this region is pushed to Central Asia via the Kunduz region, and eventually it is also sent to Europe as well. This region of Kunduz also holds importance for Taliban. That is because previously it was the stronghold of Taliban in this region, which is why the capture of Kunduz, Talokan and Saripul becomes important for the operations of Taliban. So what we see is that Taliban is increasing its expansion when it comes to Afghanistan. Now let's look into the next practice question. Which of the following statements about Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana is or correct? It is a scheme of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas for providing LPG connections to women from below poverty line households. The scheme provides financial support for each LPG connection to the BPL households, interest-free loan to purchase stove and refill by oil marketing companies. Which of the statements are correct? The answer to this is both. Why have we taken this practice question? Because this article in the PIB makes a mention of the Ujjwala scheme. What is this Ujjwala scheme? This is one of the initiatives of the Government of India. The Government of India will provide LPG connections to all those households who do not have the LPG connections and are below poverty line. And in this case, the most important objective is to safeguard the health of the women. Why is it safeguarding the health of the women? Because it is the women in most of the remote areas and also in the villages. They are the ones who cook. They are the ones who work in the kitchen. They are the ones who cook for the family. So they get the wood, they burn this wood, and this is equivalent to burning of the cigarettes as well. So their health is getting impacted. In order to mitigate the health issues, what we have is the Government of India, which has come up with Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So what are the objectives of it? To empower women and to protect their health, to minimize the health issues arising from use of unclean fossil fuel and other fuel while cooking, to control indoor pollution from the use of fossil fuel which causes respiratory issues, to prevent degradation of the purity of the environment that is compromised by widespread usage of the unclean cooking oil. Now, what we have to discuss is in reference to Ujjwala 2.0. The earlier program is Ujjwala 1. Now what we have is Ujjwala 2. Along with the deposit-free LPG connection, what Ujjwala 2 will provide is the first refill along with the hot plate free of cost to the beneficiaries. So the first refill will be free of cost. The hot plate that will be provided along with the cylinder, that will be free of cost. The enrollment procedure during this Ujjwala 2 will require minimal paperwork, and at the same time, migrants will also not be required to submit the ration cards or the address proof under the Ujjwala 2.0. These are some of the upgrades that have been done under Ujjwala 2.0. Now let's look into the next practice question. With reference to 888 uprising, which of the following statements are correct? It was a series of protests and marches in Hong Kong. It was against mainland China's proposal to introduce a new national security law. Which of the statements are correct? The answer to this is none. Why have we taken this practice question? Because this article here speaks about the 1988 uprising. Why is it called as 8888 uprising? That is because this can be written as 8, which means 8th of August in the year 1988. Where did it happen? It happened in the country of Myanmar. So kindly remember, it is not in Hong Kong, but it happened in Myanmar, where people took up arms against the government. There were a series of protests, marches and riots in the country of Myanmar. Basically, there was the military rule that was existing in Myanmar from a very long time. People were not happy with the military rule. They felt that there were large-scale unemployment as well. Their liberty was stripped off by the military and its political parties. So what did the people do? They came up with an uprising where they wanted complete control on the political, economic, and social affairs in their country so that poverty can be eliminated. So it was the military which was controlling the Myanmar polity. So what they wanted was a transition from the military to the civilian leadership, and at the same time the authoritarian regime was to be disbanded, and what they wanted was the multi-party democracy. Its relevance for today includes keeping the spirit of the democracy, underscoring the equality of federalism, and at the same time building and creating an awareness about the hegemony of the military. We recently did see the military coup in Myanmar as well. So this 1988 uprising reinforces that the military will have to be replaced by the civilian leadership. It is this that we have to understand in reference to this article. Now let's look into the next practice question. Island of Evia, recently seen in news, is part of which country? Is it Italy, Greece, Turkey, or France? The answer to this is Greece. Why have we taken this practice question? Because this article here makes a mention of island of Evia. So where is this island of Evia? This is part of Greece. It happens to be the second largest Greek island. And in the present situation, there was large-scale wildfires in the region. Their homes were destroyed, their forests were destroyed, and people had to take control over their forests to bring an end to these wildfires. Now let's look into the next practice question. Consider the following statements. The Parliamentary Committee on Public Accounts consists of not more than 25 members of the Lok Sabha, scrutinizes appropriation and finance accounts of the government, examines the report of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Which of the statements given above is or correct? The answer to this is 2 and 3 only. This happens to be a previous year question from the year 2013. Why is the first statement wrong? That is because it is not 25 members, but instead it is 22 members, where 15 will be from Lok Sabha and about 7 will be from the Rajya Sabha, which is why the first option is wrong. Eliminating the first option, we are left with 2 and 3 only. So the answer is 2 and 3. Now let's look into the fact of the day. The fact of the day for today's discussion is World Tribal Day. The World Tribal Day is celebrated every year on August 9th. It is also called as the International Day of World's Indigenous People or the World Tribal Day. Why was this day called as the World Tribal Day? That is because the first meeting of United Nations Working Group on the Indigenous Populations in Geneva took place in 1982 on 9th of August, which is why every year World Tribal Day is celebrated on 9th of August. What is the objective of World Tribal Day? It is observed in order to promote and protect the rights of the world's indigenous population. Mother Earth hosts different types of species, but it is the human beings who are detrimental to the Mother Earth as well as to the different species. Within the human community itself, there is large-scale segregation and division of the people. The rich and the poor, the equal and the unequal, there is division among the religion, race, caste, sex, so on and so forth. And added to this, there is division amongst the human beings, where there are one set of people who live in the so-called urban setup, and there are also people who are part of the forest areas called as the tribals. But of late, what we are doing is not respecting the rights of these tribal people people. So respecting and giving their legitimate rights to the tribal people is the basic objective of this World Tribals Day. So there are some rights, there are some obligations, there are some duties that we have to perform to respect the rights of the tribals. That is why we celebrate the World Tribals Day. So giving them their legitimate rights is the importance of this day. And added to it, there are different types of tribal people who have also contributed to the glory of the earth. They have also contributed to the environmental sustainability as well. So identifying them and accepting their achievements, making them part of the economic political process is the objective of World Tribal Day. The theme for the year 2021 is leaving no one behind, indigenous people, and the call for a new social contract. What is a social contract? It is an unwritten agreement that societies make to cooperate for socio and economic benefits. We do give up certain rights. We also expect certain duties from the society. We have some obligations towards the society. We give up on few rights so that there is harmony in the society. But this social contract that we signed has only included the urban setup, the rural setup, but this has completely left away those who are seated in the forest. So bringing them under the fold of the political setup, so they are also generating the economic prosperity is the need of the theme. So leaving no one behind means that the indigenous people, the tribal community should not be left out when it comes to the development. So development, what we feel might be totally different from them. So what they feel should be taken into picture, their value system should be considered, their ethos should be considered, they ultimately should be part of the political system, says this article. So this would enhance their abilities to actively participate in the political and economic activities of the nation, and at the same time, this new social contract should have a genuine participation from the tribal society, where we award them opportunities and rights, dignity and freedom, so that they would also be able to take part in the decision making, so that we can reconcile with the indigenous people and their value system. It is this that we have to understand in reference to the World Tribal Day. So this is it for today. Thank you for watching. All the best.